Okay, it's 11:46. Oh, is it 11:46 or 12? Oh, see, I messed up. I just looked at the time on my phone. What a loose term. 12:43 p.m. It's 11:26:2017. It's November 26, 2017. My wife and I did these yesterday. We put down the garlic over there. We have five rows. Should be five rows. With I don't know how many garlics exactly in between, but between 120 and 150 rows garlic should be there. And then we came out here and we peeled all that stuff back, picked up the well, I call them makeshift, but you know, they served their purpose. And I learned a little bit again. See, every year I learn a little bit something. Those fences, using a roll of 50-foot roll, which I cut in half so that it gives me 100 feet, and then I make them in like 4 foot or 3 foot sections or so, with tomato stakes in them. Before, I had the low end close to the ground so the vine could grab it, only to find out it should have the longest part between the fence and the ground so that it vines up to the highest point and then goes across. So I changed them as much as I could. There's a few that still need to be changed for next year. I don't think I'm going to be doing anything with the west end of this garden back here. Maybe in spring, that's it. This one here, it was tilled up. It wasn't tilled up real finely because of the tiller I have is an old piece of junk tiller. There's no reverse, only forward. And man, it's rough to hold it. My wife has had, she come out and do it with me, and she'll sink it down. But see, this today was too moist. It was real like mud almost. It was real hard to break up. So, you know, it took a long time, and it's more chunks than that. Just the very, very top is kind of like fine. But like when she was doing it the other day, I think right here, look at this one, how finely it looks, the soil. I mean, we both did this one, but it was drier. And you can see as a result, it's like this, down about 8 inches. Same thing here where we put the garlic. And that one there was moist because it's more shady earlier. And that was the last thing I did, and I was so tired, and it was getting too dark. I didn't videotape any of this until this morning. I did a video on those two gardens and the garlic garden. And this is garden three, west, north, east. So I got the northeast half tilled up here. We both came out here, we pulled the plastic off, and we folded it up, and we got these cement blocks. And I'm still going to probably put some more cement blocks on here. Because the winds out here are, I mean, I swear, I cannot exaggerate. I'm not exaggerating. I cannot say it's strong enough. It's like the winds from hell. Because, you know, it's pulled up, plastic gets put stuff out in the middle of that field out there and everything else. So don't put nothing past this wind out here. So I'm going to get some more cinder blocks somewhere by the side garden. I don't know if we're going to even put that over there next year for the pepper. Because I want to put basil on the very far end, three or four. Maybe one in the back, one over here, and the corners like. And we'll have tomatoes, maybe peppers here. And I don't know, and something else. Watermelon and cantaloupe will probably be over on this side over here. And again, I don't know what else. Okra will probably be either in one or two over here. We're going to put plastic on these in the spring. When I say spring, I'm talking about like late February. Because as of the 1st of February, I'm going to unfold this back on here for it to start heating up the ground. And that'll give me about probably about a good month and a half. By the second week of March, it'd be ready to plant out here with this plastic. It gives you 10 degrees warmer of the soil. So, but yeah, this is, it's not hard, but it ain't easy, man. I tell you what, my wife and I both in our 50s, and me with bad knees, her with ankle and hip. I'll tell you what, and both our backs, basically. This is not that easy. It's not impossible. It's just hard to do. But we did it because we would rather have cleaner food than that. My only regret is leaving this open because of all the spraying shit they do in the sky. So I had to put shit in there, right? That'll contaminate the ground. The plastic helps deter from it, except for the openings where we had plants and whatnot. But, you know, overall, now this is all going to get saturated with rain, with the chemicals from the sky that they spray. And if you don't know what that is, well, you know, you just check yourself out anytime now. So anyway, this is going to stay until like the first, about the middle. I might do it in the middle of January, you know, because the weather down here, it'd be in the 50s in January sometimes. Hopefully we're going to get a new tiller. Well, what we have basically is a cultivator. It breaks up the ground real hard, you know, with the tines. But, you know, you can spin it finely and get it fine, which is what we did in the last past years in previous videos. But we'll get us a tiller. I'm saying maybe January. My wife says December. I said, well, we can wait till like January. And I want to save as much money as I can to get one for around $350 or better. The one I have, I'm going to ask my neighbor over there if he wants to buy it. He's a good mechanic. He does all kind of odd and end work and whatnot. James. And I'm going to see if he wanted to take that off my hands. Well, not take it off my hands, but buy it off my hands. Real cheap, but he'll fix it up. And him and his, I believe it's his nephew or son-in-law or brother-in-law, rather, live over there, and his wife and another two or three people. So. But he wanted a tiller before. He wanted to borrow it, and I said, well, it's messed up, and you got to know a lot of things to get started and then to keep it started, which you've seen on previous videos of mine with me cussing about it, and that makes worse with my back and everything else. So anyway, so we might put this back. We're going to unfold this in January, I think. Anywhere from the first week to the second week of January, it'll be unfolded so I can start heating up. And we'll have a new tiller or a cultivator, whichever, to do this. I don't need to go down 18 inches, which is what I had done in the past lots of times. My wife and I both, man, you go down there, it would go down to almost your shin or your knee. But there's no reason for all that right now, especially with the plastic and all. I did the outside for my watermelon, I mean for my watermelon, for my sunflowers. It's gonna be a big U. I keep looking on Google Maps, and you can see this garden out here with the plastic across it, but I didn't really pay attention to the big U. If you see a big U, those are going to be sunflowers. Torch mainly. Now it's going to be more torch than anything else. That's a torch in that, what do you call it, that tire right there is a torch. Those orange flowers. They get butterflies and everything else. Hummingbirds. A lot of monarchs. Monarchs go to these, I mean, as rare as they are. They've been coming around here in August. But they get butterflies, hummingbirds, and honeybees. And the yellow sunflowers will be sporadic in between here also. Not as much as I did last year, but I want a thicker fence to keep from their offspring from that field over there and out back there. See, where are those others, those dead ones right there? Those were the torch sunflowers there. I had a few of the yellow sunflowers in there too, but I'm going to primarily have like that, with the exception of the yellow, my three or four in the yellow in between those. You know, I'll put more torch right there, right behind Lucy's cross. And so I'll have some kind of a barrier. It's not much, but it's something. So it's just this open wind like this out here. Because I don't want Monsanto out here with bad enough that shit gets in the groundwater. There I go with that word again. So I'm going to have to put a language warning, because a lot of people wet their panties when they hear shit or fuck or anything like that. They're, oh my God. Oh my God, did you hear what he said? Oh my God, I don't know if I can do it. Whatever, get a fucking life. Anyway, excuse my mouth. But that's it. Had to put that stuff in there just so I can put the warning about language. Do something, folks. Your government is not the answer. And the liberals, which aren't liberals, and those people that call themselves the Democrats, I mean Democrats, those are communists. And the Republicans, 80% of them, same thing. They're socialists / communists. They're trying to destroy the country as it is. You need to try getting yourself a place where you can grow some food, even if it's like half the size of this one here. You know, if you can get like 10 by 10, that would be great. Grow about five things in there, about three rows of each. And then you'd have some vegetables, fresh vegetables. Get heirloom seeds, if at all possible, heirloom solutions. Is where I get mine, and everything I've ever grown before, one seed, one plant, every time. I think out of let's just say a round off number, say 1,000, I put down 1,000 seeds, 997 have grown. So there might be three, but I mean, I might have had one tomato or one something not come up fully, but the rest have all come out, one seed, one plant. So I don't put down three seeds like some people do and then let them grow. I get one seed, one plant. So that's it. Hope everybody had a happy, warm beginning of a genocide day a couple days ago. And, you know, had their turkey. We have a day of thanks, but we don't celebrate that holiday of the onslaught that they brought to this country, to this land, not this country. Anyway. That's the second video, the one I did earlier, the first two, which I uploaded, but I didn't put it online. It's already uploaded on YouTube. So I'll put this one on and let it upload, and then I'll transfer the other one onto to Facebook, which is a shill site, which I go on there once in a while for just a few things. But Minds.com is the one I suggest, and I really highly recommend Minds, M-I-N-D-S.com, all capital letters, if you want to make a difference. There it is. That's supposed to make a difference. It does.